Heather thinks about software.
This week, NASA announced a partnership with IBM to release an open-source AI model to analyze satellite images of the Earth to be hosted on the Hugging Face website. The model, released under the Apache 2.0 software license, has about 100 million parameters. But what does open-source AI mean? In the last years, there has been a lot of discussion about open washing. No, not that, but describing something as open source when it's not. Open source software has been such a wild success that lots of people want to apply the open source model to other things, hardware, data, and AI, but also some unexpected things like meat, seeds, satyrs, and even sex toys. The problem is that no one knows what open source AI actually is at this point. And even worse, there's a huge company called OpenAI, which is the epitome of not open. And ethics licenses like RAIL applied to popular AI models have all kinds of restrictions. They're not open source either. So we are standing at a crossroads without a clear path. And there are two reasons for that, one technical and one philosophical. First, on a technical level, machine learning models are not software. Software is written by humans or something like that. Machine learning models are trained. They learn on their own automatically based on the input data provided by humans. There are no human instructions in a model. When programmers want to fix a computer program, they know what they need, the source code. But if you want to fix a model, you need more. Software to train it, data to train it, a plan for training it, the random seed used to train it, and so forth. There are more moving parts. And so, second, there is no consensus on an equivalent to the open source definition when applied to machine learning. The open source definition, which was made for software, has been around for 20 years and more, but it only works for software. To figure out what open source AI might be, we have to go back to first principles. For something to be open source, it needs to have an important quality, transparency. No, not that kind. Transparency means you can study it. But machine learning models right now are black boxes. For example, what if an AI is screening you for a job or for a medical treatment or deciding a prison sentence? You want to know how it works. The problem is that models right now are a black box. If you look at the output of the model, it's impossible to tell how or why the model came up with it. And all you can do is look at the inputs and training criteria to see if its training was correct. That's not nearly as easy as looking at source code. Transparency is necessary if AI is to be used to benefit our society. We need a definition of open source AI that we can rely on. AI can be hugely beneficial to our world, but first we need to trust it. And to trust it, it needs to be open and transparent. The bad news is that there is no such definition now, and plenty of models out there calling themselves open or open source. We need our thinking to catch up to the technology. The good news is that a lot of people are thinking about this issue. In the future, you as a consumer can demand that AI you use is open. As a voter, you can demand that AI used by the government is open. And as a developer, you can know your rights to use open source AIs. But for that, we need a definition. And what about NASA's open source model? Releasing under Apache 2.0 is a good choice. It's a true open source license. And although it's written for software, it will do in a pinch because permissive open source licenses specifically for machine learning models don't really exist yet. As software evolves towards AI, new licenses need to be written and accepted by the open source community. But until then, this release is a step in the right direction. By the way, if you want to take a look at a project of mine to write an open weights definition, I'll link to it in the description. I will also link to the model released by NASA and IBM. Liking and subscribing makes me think more.
Heather thinks about software.